Hello everybody and welcome to London. We're at the Me London Hotel and we are on a Mavinci UK training day, and we have Mr. Mavinci himself, Gideon King, who very kindly, and I've been working downstairs, working on cars, going through the theory as well as the practical of it, and Gideon has been working really hard to make sure everybody understands it and everybody gets it, and we've literally dragged him up here for just 20 minutes just to have a quick chat about the Mavinci solution, because I'm gambling that quite a few of you haven't heard of Mavinci before, which is odd because Mavinci's been going since 2012.
This is when we started the development of Mavinci. Then we put it in the hands of a few detailers for review, for Remax, and then we commercially launched 2 years ago, and it's been going strong ever since.
And Mavinci is, we're based in the UK. Gideon here, you live out in Qatar.
Yes, that's right.
But he's a London boy, born and bred. Whereabouts in London did you grow up?
Okay, so I grew up in East London, Canning Town. I went to school in Forest Gate. And then I also went to university in East London.
What did you study at uni?
Media and creative design.
Media and creative, well, to be honest, in detailing it's a very visual thing.
Yeah, that's right.
So media and creative design works well.
That's right.
And I just want to get to know Gideon yourself. So what car do you drive?
Oh, right now I drive a Silverado 2016, so that's a 4x4.
That's a big pickup truck, isn't
it? That's a pickup truck, yeah.
That's what an American cowboy has.
Yeah, that's what, yeah.
Do you have a hat with it?
No, I don't. I chose that car because one of my responsibilities is going around to other countries, driving in the Middle East, going to visit detailers in Kuwait, Saudi Arabia, so I would be able to put stuff in my trunk and be able to do some train people and just introduce the products, train them, and that was the reason why I chose that.
And that's a lot of driving you've got to do there, isn't it?
Yes, but as of now, a year and a half ago, because of the political issues, the border was closed. So now I just travel on the plane, send the products ahead of me, and do the training by just traveling as opposed to driving.
It's interesting how politics has a real impact on our industry, doesn't it?
That's right.
We're staring down the barrel of Brexit. You've obviously dealt with the Qatar, because Qatar's been cut off by all the other
Middle East
nations, isn't it?
That's right, that's right.
Do you think that's going to change anytime soon?
We're hoping that it changes. But I mean, Qatar is self-sufficient. As a matter of fact, the economy has grown since this happened, and the people that did try to do it, it didn't really work out very well financially for them. So I believe now they're going to come to the table and sit down with Qatar and open the borders, and we can be great leaders.
And so pitch the scene. We're 5 years in the future. You've made your millions of pounds, and you have a choice of any car you like in the world. What would you have?
So it will be a Bentley Mulsanne. As a matter of fact, I've been fortunate enough, because of the relationship that I have with Bentley, Bugatti, McLaren, and Lamborghini, every year I get to have a car for a whole year. So last year it was a McLaren, last year it was a Bentley Mulsanne. So I get to have that to drive it, to use it for whatever use that I want to use it for.
It's a really tough life, isn't it? I mean, how do you cope with these hardships? Just cruise on by. So if we dig further back into your history, you are also Mr. London's finest detailer.
That's right.
And so when did you start polishing cars?
Okay, so I started in 2010. I believe that's when I first held my first machine. I did a training course in the UK, and from then on I had the basics, and I started practicing on French cars. And because I was born in London, I always liked London, and so I decided to call the company London's Finest Detail.
You have introduced the brand in the presentation, and so you said you're not all about the hardness, you're not about the scales, you want something that is flexible to work with the car.
Yes.
But you had a really interesting point to make about the added gloss.
Yes.
So you've done some testing.
Yes.
And in the testing, the gloss added by the Mavinci coating, and which coating was this?
Yeah, this is the Ayamo.
This is Ayamo.
Yeah.
We'll put it on the screen because it's spelt differently from how it sounds.
Yes.
And you were doing in gloss meters, Ian's written down to me, it's 97 gloss meters at 60 degrees.
That's right.
Which is how the gloss meter reads, so at different angles. And then we have here It was 88 beforehand, so it's added 88 to 96.
90 on 20 degrees and 97 on 60 degrees.
So that's pretty impressive, and we'll put some explanations in the video about what that means as well, because basically it gets glossier, which is why I want you to see about. And now you do a couple of different coatings, so you've got the IAMA that you talked about.
That's right.
What other ones do you do?
Okay, so today we also showcase downstairs at Oracle. Oracle is something that we've been working on, a self-healing coating, which is hand applied. It's really easy to apply, so that's Oracle, that's the self-healing. That's what we've just rolled out on the market now. We also have the C16, which is a 3 years SiO2 based coating. We have the MK4 for 18 months, and we have the Overcoat, which is a temporary protection for all of the overcoatings while they get dry, while they get cured also.
And these coatings, are they purely to be applied by professionals? Or
absolutely. The reason why is because what we believe as professionals is I think one of the things that Mavinci was keen on was having professional detailers dictate the performances of products, as opposed to manufacturers rolling out products and just throwing it on the market and say this does this, this does this, this does this, and they never actually see the performance of the product. It's we're the one that has to deal with the customers. We're the one that see the performance more. So we felt like this was the time for us to take the performance and the quantifying and qualifying the products into our own hands. And then this is one of the reason why we birthed Mavinci.
And what you're talking about very much is Mavinci is sort of created in collusion with detailers for detailers.
Absolutely.
Which I think is important. As you say, they're a chemist who will create something. They say that on paper this is going to do a great job, but until you put it on paint.
That's right.
One thing Ian was wondering actually is, does it work on all paint types, including all the classic cars?
Absolutely, yes. We've tested it on all different kind of paints. It works perfectly well. Like I said, remember, we've been working on this product since 2012, so it wasn't something that we were so desperate to roll out on the market just because we wanted to make a quick buck. Something that it was needed to be on the market to be revolutionary, to be different, to be totally away from what commercial companies into coatings are known for.
And you say these are formulated and constructed in Japan?
Yeah, absolutely. Yes.
And again, a lot of these products come from Korea. There are a couple others. I know CarPro do a couple of things from Japan. There are one or two other companies, but Japan it tends to be for the very best top coatings of any particular company. It seems to come from Japan.
That's right. Going back in the history, the Japanese, they were involved in coating steels back in the day because of the weather. And that's how coating started in Asia. So they were way ahead in terms of coating. And then when we was going around and talking to a lot of scientists, and we found out that from the ones that were tested in Hong Kong or different other places, it was this specific chemist that put our eyes, and yes, we spoke to him, he reserved it for us, and then yes, from ever since we've had a relationship.
No, that's brilliant. So one thing that's really interesting also is that the range is actually small. A lot of chemical companies out there will say, okay, our coating is our champion product, but then we'll do a glass cleaner and a shampoo and all of these other things. From what I saw today,
yes,
you're very much focused on paint protection.
Yes.
Is that going to change? Are you going to expand?
Yes, that's going to change. Okay, based on a contract that we have with a specific company that we partner up with, we honor our contract, we honor our agreement, and because we're partners, we couldn't engineer a specific type of products like window cleaners and stuff like that for a short amount period of time. Well, that time has expired, so we worked on having DIY products that detailers demand, that they need for the customers to sell to the customers, or to even use after care for the customers. So yes, so we do have DIY or after care products coming up.
And how do you envisage, here we've got about 30 guys downstairs, give or take.
Yes.
How many people do you envisage? Because I know exclusivity is an important thing in making sure that you have a select group of detailers.
Yes.
And it was interesting is at the beginning of today, you didn't say this is not a training session. You literally said, look guys, this is not training. This is on the basis that you are already established detailers.
That's right.
Who already know what you're doing.
Exactly.
We will give you tips on our specific products that you might not have in other ones.
Yes.
But what are you looking for in terms of numbers for the total size of the UK? I mean, how are you apportioning territories or anything like that?
Okay, so it's important for us to help detailers grow. is important because the details are the industry, and it's, you know, for us it's been for detailers by detailers, not only just the components of the coating, but the way of life, the way that they think, what it is that they want. So everything is embedded into the coating in terms of distribution, in terms of selling, in terms of our goals, our vision. Everything is built around detailers. So it was important for us to make sure that they have exclusivity at least within a 35 to 50 mile radius exclusivity for them to be able to perform very well, and they don't have to worry. But also the exclusivity also goes two different ways. We give you exclusivity. Are you willing to give us exclusivity? Because what we do not want is just for you to seek exclusivity just because you're trying to block another guy from using the product, and you're with this guy and that coating and that coating and that coating, and you just want to hold on to our coating. So yes, we first give you that, and then we give you enough time for you to assess our coating, to observe it, to see. And if there's someone else that wants that coating and is looking for strictly exclusivity with us one-on-one, and then we will now give you the first right of refusal to say, look, do you still want to carry on using A, B, C, D and Mavinci, or do you just want to use Mavinci? If you say you want to just use A, B, C and D and Mavinci, then we will transfer it and give it to the other guys. That's how we work, and that's the honest truth.
Which is fair enough. A lot of people ask about that sort of thing. So it's good to get that out there and be clear with that. I'm guessing 35 to 50 is related to if it's in the middle of London, obviously, you've got a lot of many.
So we're talking about outside London, because in London, the market is different, the population is different, the wealth is different, the money is different, the cars is different. So yes, it's a little bit different.
That'd be cool. So just to wrap things up, if you are a detailer in the UK and you want to get in touch with yourself, what's the best way to do it?
Okay, so we have our website, and please, I'm going to repeat, the official website, because this is the head office website, is you go to www.mavinci.com and you go to contact us, and this is where we will take your inquiries, and then we answer all those. We ask you questions, you answer the questions, then we will get our COO to give you a call and have more understanding about what you want to achieve, and then see if we can take you further.
Okay, that works well. And if you are a consumer car owner and you would like Mavinci applied to your car, how do they get in contact? They just go to Mavinci.com?
Yes, so they go to Mavinci.com and also our social media page. And then once they contact us, and also what we're doing now is, so we're building links that will give you location of Mavinci detailers in the UK. And if we don't have Mavinci detailers in your area, we'll give you the nearest person to your area where they can work out calculation of cost in terms of transportation and all of this information that's needed for them to give your car the care that it needs.
Well, in the early days, it's unlikely the network is going to spread everywhere, so it might be a matter. But it's a matter of time to build up the
absolutely
network.
Absolutely.
And you don't want to rush these things, because if you do that, then you end up with a lower quality workmanship.
Exactly.
So you're going around in circles.
Exactly. And it's important for us, just like I said earlier, right? We have to validate our details. We need to see how they paint correct. You know, we need to see the passion, you know, the vision, and then if it goes with what we truly believe in ourselves, then we sit down and move forward. We just don't take everybody, not because we've been arrogant, because we have vision. And yes, I will say this, we have enough funds, so we are not desperate to make a sale. What we are desperate for is to keep our brand, our products, our detailers, our customers exclusive.
Brilliant. Well, as you can probably tell, this hotel is starting to get quite busy with revelers, so we're going to wrap it up there, let Gideon get back down,
and thank you very much.
We shall be inserting various bits of cut scenes from today into the footage, and as I say, you know, on the tape, we'll put all the links underneath, so if you do want to get in touch with Gideon, either as a detailer or as an end user, it'll be easy for you to do so. Anyway, thank you very much, Gideon.
Thank you very much for your time, man. Really, I appreciate that, man, and hopefully I'll see you guys in this.
Absolutely.
Thank you so much. Thank you.